So immediately after the eruption of 1886 with Mount Tarawera, as you might imagine, the landscape was completely and utterly changed. The eruption came up underneath Lake Rotomahana, and there was mud and debris and ash went all over the countryside. So the landscape as people knew it was completely and utterly devoid of anything that they thought they could recognize from before the eruption. During our expedition on Lake Rotomahana, we set out to see what had become of the Pink and White Terraces geothermal system after it had been drowned by the lake rising 100 odd meters. We also wanted to see if we could find any vestiges of the pre-1886 shoreline that we could recognize by mapping the lake floor today in extreme detail. So why it was key to try and find some part of the pre-1886 lakeshore that we could recognize was it meant that we could then marry the data that we have today of the lake floor with that of the maps that existed prior to the eruption in 1886. What we were able to do that previous people were not able to do is to map the lake floor in a far greater resolution. What that meant is that we saw all of a sudden detail that was not being seen before, and in particular what we found was this arcuate promontory of land that previously used to stick out from the lake shore just north of the Pink Terraces. So we knew where to go to look to if we were going to find them at all. When we take the data that we collected and we render it into a 3D model, you can see this wonderful arcuate shaped promontory we're talking about jutting into the bottom of the lake floor today. Immediately south of that, you can see this ramp, if you like, where we believe the Pink Terraces were situated in the past. We then applied side scan sonar, and the side scan sonar is looking for very, very hard objects or materials in the, sitting on the lake floor. And lo and behold, in each one of these images, if you look closely, you can see the arcuate shape, you can see the overlapping terraces, and in some cases, you can see these wonderful round, what were probably pools on top of the terraces, now infilled by sediments, and that's why they're black. And then the money shot, of course, was when we put the camera down on top of these terraces, which we found through the side scan sonar, and we found what we believe to be the buttresses of one of the terraces themselves. By the end of the expedition, we're extremely excited and very happy that we had found what we believe to be remnants of the Pink Terraces. But unbeknownst to us, we had a little secret still in store, and that is the last couple of days of gathering data from in the White Terraces region, we never actually got to process for a couple of months because of there's so many other expeditions we had to deal with at the time. When we finally got round to looking at those data, we were completely gobsmacked because there, staring us right in the face, were what we believe to be the bottom terrace or two from the White Terraces. They're exactly in the right place. So at the end of the day, it looks like we have found quite a few of the terraces from the Pinks, and there may be more, and possibly we found the bottom tier or two of the Whites. So I think what's remarkable to me is that there's been 125 years of mystery about what happened to the Pink and White Terraces, and most people thought they'd been destroyed, and why not? There was this huge, incredible eruption which devastated the landscape, and tens of meters of mud splattered for as far as the eye could see. So why wouldn't they be destroyed? What I think is truly remarkable is that we've shown that they haven't gone anywhere, particularly the Pinks and possibly the Whites, and they've been sitting there on the bottom of Lake Rotomahana for well over 100 years since they've been drowned, and they haven't gone anywhere. And so I kind of think that this is New Zealand's Titanic. And we found it, and we've brought this wonderful iconic thing back to the people, and it means a lot to many people, particularly iwi, and they know that whilst of course it was dreadful and there was a lot of loss of life and devastation of the countryside and disbursement of the iwi throughout that region, this are great iconic terraces that people revered, they're still there, they just happen to be at the bottom of the lake.